In this tutorial, we showcase how to use droplets from a flip simulation to source a ripple simulation and merge everything together. We start by importing mocap data into Houdini using the FBX character import node. Using the first output, we modify the mesh to only keep the lower geo, colliding with our flip simulation. With the third output, we leverage the KineFX motion clip workflow to resample, retime, and loop the animation. Looping the animation is done with the motion clip cycle node. We use the hips as locomotion join to offset the new cycle. After offsetting the simulation frame to the point where the foot is just about to hit the ground, we apply a transform, compute the V attribute, and move on to creating the particle tank. We drop down an ocean source node in flat mode to create our puddle. After decreasing particle separation and increasing the density, we resize it and dive inside to increase the number of particles at surface level. The flip simulation will happen at OBJ level, where the flip object fetches particles from our tank, and the static object fetches our collision as deforming geometry. A couple of parameters will help achieving a splashy simulation, like reducing the gravity, increasing velocity scale from the collision, and not smoothing our velocity field. After that, we face the issue of the particles not being able to leave our simulation. We still need the water surface to be contained, but not the droplets. To achieve that, we create a droplet group based on the droplet attribute and introduce a particle separation step for the particle flying high. Then inside our solver, we specify that only the particle not part of that group collide with the tank. Finally, in order to get rid of particle leaving the tank from the bottom, we remove particle under a certain height. In order to make a surface out of the flip simulation, we use the dope ion node to import it to a subcontext. We compress it while keeping the under-resolve attribute and cache it to disk. We then use the particle fluid surface node, and to prepare the step where we merge it with ripples, we enable the flatten geometry option and disable the adaptivity. To refine our geo at the boundaries, we dive inside to increase the erosion step of the flattening VDB and move it down a little. After caching it to disk, we time shift it to the first frame to start creating our ripple surface. To prepare the merging step, we want the ripple surface to surround the original geo while keeping a primitive group that replicates it. To achieve that, we use a match size to offset it to a corner and copy transform it along the X and Z axis 3 times using the B-box expression. After fusing it, we transfer the origin group to be able to separate it later. We now focus on displacing this flat surface every time a droplet comes in contact. To do that, we isolate the points from our flip simulation that have an under-resolved attribute superior to .5. The points leave that selection as they collide with the ground. So in order to select them, we isolate the points missing from the next frame. Because the collision happens at the next frame, we use the V attribute to project it and offset the frame by one. We achieve our displaced geo by transferring the disp attribute from the point to the surface and displacing the geo along the y-axis. The ripple simulation happens inside a sub-level dopnet, the displaced surface being our deforming rest geo. We also focus on creating some points matching the position where the fields collide with the surface to create more ripples. After importing our collision geo, we project it up onto the surface and isolate the colliding points. We create also a disp attribute that scales with the distance to the surface. In order to write to disk a compressed version of the ripple simulation, we can cache the first frame as reference and then remove the point close to the rest position. We then use the index attribute to match each point to the simulated position and the attribute to achieve our final ripple surface. We now focus on merging the flip surface and ripple surface. Our first step is to define a mask value to isolate the flat parts of our flip surface. Using that attribute, we can increase the flatness of the surface towards the end of the simulation. Then we import our ripple surface and separate the origin group. By taking inspiration from the merge oscillant flip workflow, we can merge the ripple into the flip simulation by defining a displace attribute that reflects how much bump we need to transfer to the flip surface. We then convert this attribute into a volume along with Z. Then, from the flip surface, we sample the volume and displace it using the mask as a filter. The last steps are to merge everything together. We can use the fuse node to finish closing the gaps between the inner and exterior surface. And finally, to render, we can use the droplets as particles, either scaled along the velocity or with motion blur.